for those of you that have been here since Wednesday, you heard a lot of good advice from a lot of folks that have what I'll call legends in the industry. We all have a good story to tell. We all have good tips to give you guys about what to do. There are certain pointers about how to handle your career, which you're about to start on. You're essentially listening to a bunch of folks, myself included, who in 10 years from now, we don't count anymore. In 10 years from now, the people that will be running this world are you folks. And the people that are influencing the world in that direction that we're going to be in 10 years from now are, again, you folks. So what I want to talk about today is not my career, because a stammering, stuttering, unemployed guy coming to Chicago looking for a job, working in the Chicago pit, and I was fortunate in getting promoted and being where I am now. When somebody asked me what the secret to my success was, I always tell them, work for old folks, because they're going to die soon, and then you can take over. But that's not entirely true. But let me talk a little bit about the problem that we at the CME Group have. We have been combining with all the exchanges, the Chicago Board of Trade, NYMEX, COMEX, Citi. And so we have a cultural formation issue. We have so many other issues. We're working on them for one reason and one reason only. We want to be attractive to you, because in 5 years from now, every one of you here are going to be, if my guess is correct, with some exceptions, are going to be 75% of the workforce because of how young you are and what you're about to actually start. So I want to talk to you about a recruitment issue that we have. It's not just CME, but many of the companies, not just in Chicago, but in the U.S., we are seeing that turnover is going up. We are seeing that the recruitment process is good, and we're seeing a lot of good things in terms of the talent that is there now. We're also seeing what our employees are thinking about us, that we don't have a good enough plan, we don't do enough for our employees, and these are the emerging and the young employees. Now, in 2021, which is when you guys are smack in the workforce, because of who you are, and I'll talk about who you are, who we think you are, this will be an issue for folks such as myself, but it will not be an issue with respect to every one of you guys, because in 2021, the opportunities are truly global. From a global perspective, the opportunities you have extend beyond the U.S., all right? Now, there have been generalizations formed about how each of the classes think. So let me start here. Boomers have these qualities as a whole. Gen X, which is a very small size, have a different set of qualities, and they are driving somewhat of an impact on the world. You folks, the future of the world, you're very large, you're group-oriented, you're idealistic, and you're socially conscious. Not every one of you, but generally, as an employer, we need to understand you in a way that makes sense to us, in a way that makes sense to the businesses, not just that we currently run, but the businesses that we want to continue to run as the world evolves. In 2008, you were nowhere, right? In 2013, you are emerging. In 2018, you guys will be about half the workforce. Half the workforce. And in 2018, to the point I made a short while ago, the baby boomers like myself are on the way out, if not already out, right? So the human resources departments of a whole bunch of firms are thinking about how their world is going to look like, who they want to hire, and who are these people that are coming into their firms who individually will change the firm and collectively is going to change the way the world looks. So this is how you are thought about, all right? You will be 75% of the workforce very soon. You're not loyal. not necessarily bad, because you want to make a difference. If you can't make a difference, you want to leave. The way our generation primarily worked, with few exceptions, they would stay and bitch about what a bad place it was to actually work. The fact that you're not loyal and you want to make a difference, to me, to our company, very, very good. Culture counts. That's why CME focuses a lot on the culture that we have and try to avoid some of the pitfalls of a bad culture. When you've always lived with cell phones, you've always had the internet, you get your information not from print media, not from TV, but online. And they're not necessarily consistent. It's not being sold by anybody. You get your viewpoints about the world from public opinion, right? You're ethnically and racially diverse, which is good, right? When I joined the CME in 1988, I would characterize the workforce then as white male, right? So it's an interesting world. We got to understand the world and we worked around the world. The CME now is a far cry from where it was 25 years ago. You support things that were looking to solve an issue rather than some ideology. You are the best educated generation in history, coming into an environment that doesn't have enough jobs to support every single one of you. So, what do you do? I don't have a clue, right? Right? But one thing that binds you to almost every other generation that has come through, money, stability actually counts, okay? That's the one thing that is good. The generation before you, my generation, has accumulated more wealth than all the previous generations combined. So we still call the shots. Your wallet share, though, is growing, and is growing fast. So at one of these days, because the internet is what you grew up with, if I talk to you about library systems and how to find books, you'll all fall asleep. But that's how we grew up, doing research, trying to understand how the world works. Any problem I have, any question I have, I just bounce on the net and I get my answers now. The world's going to change to accommodate you guys as you enter the workforce. So the question I have for all of you is, not all is being lost. You have to ask yourselves, how do I make a difference? How do I come in? Every single one of you have an impression about the companies that you work for, whether it's CME, whether it's one of the firms, whether it's TT. If you think about the world, and if you think about how to go about making your way in this world, certain things are very key for every single one of you. First and foremost, mindset. Have a positive mindset, a growth mindset. Understand that the world's not always bad. You have a fixed mindset. You don't want to change your mind. That almost describes my 15-year-old son. But having a growth mindset and understanding what growth mindset means is important. Be mindful. Many of these characteristics tell me that you guys are mindful. You are the generation that's going to make the world a better place in the work that you folks do. But understanding how to act and understanding how to think will become very, very key. There's a guy in Google whose title is Jolly Good Fellow. It is a real title, it's a real job, and he wrote a book. It's a book about mindfulness, and it goes beyond meditation. It goes about thinking deeply about things that actually count, all right? I've seen so many people come to the CME, brilliant guys, very, very smart, and they could not fit into the organization because they tried to get the organization to fit into them. This is what's happening in our society now. Companies like ours are changing the way we look at the labor force coming in to fit into the labor force. First time in the history of time that we are fitting what we see coming to us, because this is the generation, you guys, that are doing things differently, that are thinking differently, and the old guys like myself have to get out of the way, because the change that you guys are going to drive is going to make the world a better place for us. Understanding how to act and how to become that is going to be key. Success is not going to be in front of you. The two things you have to do that's very important: be a sponge, absorb as much information as you can, And finally, never give up. Don't give up no matter what. You're going to learn something every day. You're going to learn about bad people, good companies, not so good firms. But in the end, you will find what you want. If you follow simple principles, don't give up, understand the environment you work in, be mindful, and finally, watch your elbow, right? Elbows are interesting things. You don't know they're there until they're hurt, right? Egos are the same way. You don't think you have one until somebody hurts it. Watch your elbows. Take yourself out of the picture when you're trying to make a decision, when you enter the workforce, and you find the answers a lot clearer than if you put yourself in the middle of any one of those. Happy to talk to you later, but thank you all.